There is actually some overlap between carpal tunnel syndrome and tendonitis. Some types of tendonitis are actually thought to contribute to carpal tunnel syndrome as they can sort of increase the swelling in the carpal tunnel, which is an area at the base of the hand right here at the wrist. The symptoms of carpal tunnel syndrome and tendonitis are somewhat different, however, even though they are somewhat related. Carpal tunnel syndrome typically begins with sort of a pain and more so a numbness and tingling that can involve the palm and then some of the fingers, particularly the thumb, the index finger, and the middle finger. It's very common that people say that carpal tunnel syndrome or their symptoms of carpal tunnel syndrome are sort of worse at nighttime or even while driving. It seems to be that at nighttime, people, whether we realize it or not, have a tendency to sleep with our wrists in a flexed position, kind of like this. And so that sort of leads us to some of the treatment options for carpal tunnel syndrome, which would include nocturnal carpal tunnel bracing or splinting, where we actually try to sleep with the wrist in a more neutral position to relieve some of the pressure in this carpal tunnel and hopefully alleviate some of those symptoms of the pain, the numbness, and the tingling.
So Dr. Dunbar, what about wrist tendonitis?
So wrist tendonitis or tendonitis of the hand and wrist is a very common thing we see here at Ochsner. We have lots of tendons around our fingers and wrists that help us with basically all the movements throughout these many joints there. They're all predisposed to getting inflamed and irritated as they pass through tight little tunnels or rub on top of bony prominences. But we can get tendonitis really anywhere around the wrist, very commonly on the ulnar side of the wrist over here, or even on the radial side over here. That would be called de Quervain's tenosynovitis, which is a very common condition we see and can really be significantly painful for patients.
How do you get wrist tendonitis? Is it one activity over time, or is it one activity over a weekend?
So that's a great question. Different people develop tendonitis from different activities. I think certainly it can be from a particularly strenuous weekend of, say, tennis or golfing. But more commonly, I'd say it's slightly more gradual in onset as people develop it with their typical activities of daily living. Even simple things just as feeding ourselves, dressing ourselves, taking care of ourselves. We obviously use our fingers and hands for all those activities. And so basically just from living our normal lives, everyone is sort of at risk for tendonitis, unfortunately. So it is very common.